Any other next question, please? Waalaikumsalam
warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. I am Adriana binti Nazrisham from Permata Insan College. My question: how do you manage to raise your daughters to become successful preachers internationally, while women publicly perceive as weak and fragile? Thank you.
If I heard the question correctly, how do you make the daughters become successful as preachers, you said? Preachers or teachers? Preachers. P. How do you make your girls as successful preachers so that they are able to give public speeches, etc.? It is compulsory that every Muslim should do dawah. According to the glorious Quran, according to Surah Al-Asr, chapter 103, verse number 1 to 3, it mentions, Wal Asr, innal insana lafi khusr. By the token of time, man is verily in a state of loss. Illa allazina amanu wa amilu salihati wa tawasaw bil haqq wa tawasaw bis sabr. Except those who have faith, those who do righteous deed, those who exhort people to truth, and those who exhort people to patience and perseverance. There are minimum four criteria required for any human being to go to Jannah. Number one is Iman. Number two is righteous deed. Number three is watawasaw bil haqq, inviting people to truth. That is dawah, that is preaching. And number four is inviting people to patience and perseverance. So according to Surah Al-Asr, if anyone is missing, you shall not enter Jannah. You may be a very good Muslim. You may be praying five times a day. You may have gone for Hajj. You may be fasting in the month of Ramadan. But if you don't do dawah, if you don't preach, according to Surah Al-Asr, you shall not enter Jannah. Only dawah is not important. All four are equally important. That is Iman, righteous deed, dawah, and exhorting people to patience and perseverance. So every Muslim should at least be a part-time da'i. Compulsory. Further, Quran says in Surah Imran, chapter 3, verse 104, let there arise out of you a band of people that invite people to the truth, that enjoin good and forbid them from doing wrong. Here Allah is talking about full-time da'is. How we are full-time doctors, full-time engineers, full-time lawyers, full-time businessmen. How many full-time da'is do we have? Allah says, let there arise out of you a band of people who are full-time da'is, who are full-time preachers. These are the one to attain felicity. You know, I have done my medical studies, and I chose to become a doctor because I thought doctor was the best profession in the world. It's a good profession. But after I met Sheikh Ahmed Didad, I realized that a da'i is a better profession. And Allah says in Surah Fusilat, chapter number 41, verse number 33, Allah says, وَمَنْ أَحْسَنُ قَالَ مِمَّنْ ضَائِلَ اللَّهِ وَآمِلَ صَالِحًا قَالَ إِنِّي مِنَ الْمُسْلِمِينَ. Who is better in speech than one who invites to the way of thy Lord, works righteousness, and says that I am Muslim? When I realized that da'i is far superior than a doctor, I changed from a doctor of body to a doctor of soul. It was the desire of my mother that I become someone like Dr. Chris Bernard. Dr. Chris Bernard was the first cardiologist, heart surgeon, who did the first heart transplantation. But when I asked her, when I got inspired by Sheikh Didad, who also come from South Africa, do you want me to become like Sheikh Didad or Dr. Chris Bernard? She said both. Later on, when I got involved in the field of dawah and I asked her the same question, do you want me to become like Sheikh Didad or Chris Bernard? She said, I can sacrifice 1,000 Dr. Chris Bernard for one Sheikh Didad. Now coming to your main question, that how do you make your daughters as preachers? And I said that I'll make all my children, irrespective whether the daughter or son, I'll make them as preachers. Because that is the best profession. It is the profession of the Anbiyas, of the messengers of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And we started a school in Bombay. In our school, it is education for both the worlds. When children study in the school, we want them to give education for both the worlds. So when a child joins the school at the age of 2.5, when he joins nursery, from nursery, we teach that child Arabic and English. And we teach the other local languages also, Hindi, Urdu, Marathi, 5 languages. But 2, we make them very strong. The international language, English, and the language of the Quran, Arabic. And then Urdu, Hindi, Marathi. By the time they reach standard 5, they can understand the Quran. Those who select Hifz, they become Hafiz by the time they reach standard 5. And by the time they reach standard 9 or 10, they can translate the Quran to a great extent. Physical fitness is compulsory. Every student, girl or boy, by the time they reach standard 6, they should be black belt in martial arts. Compulsory. All my 3 children, mashallah, they Hafizul Quran. Both my daughters and my son, they are black belts. Black belt in martial arts. Alhamdulillah. They Hafizul Quran, they speak Arabic as a language, they speak English. And we teach public speaking from the age of 4. From junior KG, we teach the child how to speak in front of audiences. So our children of the age of 5, 6, 7, you see on Peace TV, they address thousands of people. They don't have the stage fear. So we also, we don't select only high IQ, we select all IQ. Only selecting high IQ and making, we select the parents, that if the parents have the passion for deen, even we have taken students of 80, even 80. You know, 80 is below average. 90 is supposed, 90 and 110 is average. I mean, below 80, you know, it goes. We have even taken students of 79 IQ. And we have students of 150 also. And we see to it that we train them to present the deen. Unfortunately, what we have, normally, if your child fails in school once, twice, thrice, then you make him Hafizul Quran. You want to make him an alim. We give the rejects of society for spreading our deen. If your child has got good IQ, 140, 150, if you can become a doctor, if you can become an engineer, then you select him for spreading the deen. Why do you want to select the worst? We want to give our best. So as far as making a dai, when do you start? When is the earliest you start thinking of making your child, irrespective of what you want to make, dai? When is the earliest? Can you guess? Can anyone guess? When is the earliest that you think? Or when is the latest? Forget the earliest. When is the latest that now is high time you have to start thinking that you have to make your son a dai? 15. Our police officer is saying 15. Can anyone improve? When is the time? Any age. If you want to be surely successful, that okay, I want to make my son a dai, or whatever it is. When is the right time? As soon as he's born. Very good. Very good, but not perfect. The best reply is when you choose your life partner. When you choose your life partner, if I want to make my children dai, I should choose a wife who's a dai. If I choose a wife who's a singer, then will my son become a dai? So the right time, the latest that you can think of making your son or a daughter a dai is when you choose your life partner. At that time, because if you want to make your son a dai, mother is the best teacher. Or if you are a girl, you should see to it that you choose a boy who's a dai. They have that same vision. Then, inshallah, you'll see to it that the product that comes out would be a dai. So, whether it's a girl or a boy, you have to have that intention and that niya from the early age. And the best person to ask help is from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And if you know the dua that Ibrahim alayhi salam made in the Quran, in Surah Hajj, that make my children people who are Muslims, who are submitting the will to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, make from them great, not only me, my children and the generation, zuriyat, from the generation. What you have to do is you have to inculcate in them that when they go to a school, normally when we are school, you know, what we have in the annual day, we have fancy dress competition. They want to behave like actors and they want to behave like pop star. In our annual day, they want to imitate Sheikh Ahmed Didat, you know, Sheikh Sudesh, for example, Sheikh Surem, the Duats. So they are inculcated in their mind from the young age that the best profession is a dai. And it's not necessary that dai means only one who can speak. He can be good in writing skills, can be a good writer, can be a good speaker, can be a good thinker. And we have dawah training program, not only in our school, we teach Quran and Hadith along with the formal education. Our degree comes from the UK board, Cambridge. So no one can say it's an Indian degree or a Muslim degree, UK board. And once you pass from this Cambridge, Cambridge is the most acceptable throughout the world. You can take admission after A level in any part of the world. Simultaneously, we teach them Sharia, Fiqh, Hadith. Not only Quran, Hadith, we teach them Bible. We teach them Veda. We teach them how to speak with a non-Muslim, with Hikmah. Then we have a Dawah training program where we train. Today research tells us that when a person speaks in public, the matter he speaks is only 7% marks. How much? 7. The presentation skills is 93%. How you talk, how do you modulate, your hand gestures, your eye-to-eye movement. All this carries 93% marks. So we train this from a young age so that they can become good duats. But natural, in our thing, the ladies give lectures to lady audience and gents can give to gents as well as mixed audience. That is as per the teachings of the Sharia. And mashallah, many a times when my family goes, not only myself, even my wife gives lecture, even my son gives lecture, even my daughters. You know, we are there in Malaysia for the past about 12 days. Mashallah, my son has given many lectures. I have given many lectures. My wife has given, my daughters have given lectures. And our hafiz that we produce in our school, see, a normal hafiz can recite the Quran from first to the last, but they can't quote chapter number, verse number. You ask them which verse of the Quran speaks about Big Bang, they'll not tell you. They can recite from beginning to the ending, fine. But in between asking, we have many a time the program, ask the hafiz or ask the hafizah. That means you can ask them anything from the Quran and they will tell you. You can recite any verse of the Quran, they can continue. You give the English translation, they will translate in Arabic and continue. They will tell that whether it's Makki or Madni surah, which chapter it belongs to, which surah it belongs to. So that they are not just hafiz or huffaz, they are well trained. That requires a better. So when they finish the hifz in standard 5, they do muraja, they do repetition, they do revision. So that it gets ingrained in their memory. So if you want to make your child a dai, it is better late than never. Some people are already married, you cannot remarry again. It is better late than never. Put your child in a school which has that vision. Most of the school, they try and make your children imitate like pop singer or a sports star, which will not benefit you. And believe me, actually, if we analyze that, normally if you see around us, that how they show, you know, oh, if you become a pop star, you'll have so many likes on the Facebook, and when you go, you become a sportsman and you see on the Facebook. I do agree that, you know, the sportsman has better likes or the pop singer, but who is the most famous human being in the world? Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Was he a sportsman? Was he a singer? No, he was a dai. messenger of Allah. So if we ingrain in our children the value of a dai, otherwise today in most part of the world the dais are looked down upon. Dai is the best profession. And believe me, if you take my example, even if I'd been the best doctor in the world, I would not have got this honor, what I'm getting. And I'm sure you wouldn't have called me in this school. With all this honor that Allah has given, we didn't do for this, we did it for sake of Allah. And Allah gives you multiple times more. So I believe that if you should have that vision and see to it that you train towards giving the message of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So a child, if he wants, he should make a vision, who's your role model? Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, if you see the wives of the Prophet Ummahatul Mumineen, if you see Hazrat Aisha, may Allah be pleased with her. And these should be a role model, and inshallah, you'll be able to present the deen. Hope that answers the question.
That people really put as the absolute truth when we know it is not. But what we know from science is the following. What is happening is that the earth has been rotating around its axis since the creation of the universe. In the beginning, our earth used to complete one complete circle around its axis in 4 hours. It used to be very fast, and it has been slowing down since then. Now it completes one rotation around its axis in 23 hours, 56 minutes and 4 seconds. And scientists know that the speed is going to diminish.